What's up guys, welcome back from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Tool video. UA Ultra Athletes, they got more support, let's try it out, it's up on Edo Pro. This is the current main deck. You might be like, what, like 44 cards? Couple of reasons. First of all, Isolde was playtesting the deck without like this, that small Isolde package here on the right, like Red Lair. The Renault as well, the Phoenix Blade potentially discard fodder for Ace, which is their negation card, I guess, next to a Blockbacker, the big walls, I guess, that you want to end on. They let you interact during your opponent's turn, but Isolde, I think you need to run it, definitely, because again, the search, the beneficial search, most of the time, depending on your hand, but the deck has the ability to play during your opponent's turn, and thanks to one of the new cards being managed, UA Plane Manager. The deck now somewhat has like a boss monster. It gives you the potential effect failure for all monsters, I guess, during the opponent's turn, for example, when it's dropped to the field as soon as you special summon like an UA monster to the field, or it will pop something. So definitely a solid card. It can also be like an extender. Again, I mean, the deck definitely has possibilities, right? More new support. The deck also got a new field spell, your Hyper Stadium. It's pretty straightforward. I think you need to max out on both field spells since they work super well together. You have Hyper Stadium that lets you, it's basically a searcher, the rota from the deck when it's activated. Plus, the second effect is also beneficial. It gives your deck like an extra normal summon. And, well, there is like that small cost that you need to reveal another field spell in the hand. But that's where UA Stadium comes into play. As you know, Stadium, again, gives you like a search every time an UA monster is normal summoned. So, you see, the beneficial normal summon already could equal into two searches. So that's where the potential pluses of this deck lie, right? So as you saw, I mean, the extra deck is basically filler. It's Isolde is the most important card, and then, well, you can basically fill it in with other cards, right? But Appaloosa might be an important one if you do opt to go for like the Isolde package. Not really sure if I want to really main deck or go well over 40 cards, maybe into 50 cards to make Isolde like more life and giving me the ability to go for a level 4 special summon from the deck, but that seems a bit too bricky. The fact that I'm also running a little over 40 cards, that is that I recently added Nibiru as well. I mean, I was playtesting against like top tier, against Eldritch, well, Synchro, Dot Deck, Aurorodon, Shenanigans, and Dinosaurs as well, basically the same deck, well, the same extra deck engine. And if you're going second, the deck can't really do much. You're really hoping that you're like drawing your blossoms, your hand traps, like Blossom, and I'm not running impermanence, but you could, definitely an option. But if it's not for them, you can't break a board. The Ultra Athletes, well, okay, they do have like some options, but the engine as a whole is still too fragile, and it's also somewhat weak to disruption. Anyway, so this is one of the reasons why I definitely like something as beneficial as Isolde, and trying to maximize her effects, I guess, with the Red Lair, getting it back with Renault, and two equip spells being the Phoenix Blade. Phoenix Blade, I guess, is okay, because the level 5 Ace has the ability to negate everything from your opponent once per turn, obviously, but you have to discard the card, and like this one, Perfect Ace. But for this at least for this deck, discarding a card is quite heavy. This is not a deck that you're like, oh man, I can gain like huge advantage. Let's say like Sky Strikers, for example. That's definitely not the case. So an extra discard card that's somewhat of a plus. You know what I mean? That's welcome. And if you can send it to the graveyard basically for free due to Isolde, yeah, why not, right? And yeah, why not? The biggest reason why you might not want to run like that small Isolde package, or maybe like, you know, there are definitely other warrior engines, is like consistency, if that makes sense. Just the fact that you're running over 40 cards, right? So yeah, I guess you could run or drop like the Isolde package, and with that I mean like Red Lair, the Renault, and Phoenix Blade. And, well, yeah, Isolde on her own is, it's basically an extra searcher, I guess, but that's the biggest problem here. of the Arctap is that the it works really similar, I guess, to Cosmo, and you don't really want to like sacrifice your smaller pilots, if you know what I mean. And that's the same for this. You want to keep tanging out with your level force, both level force, for example, right? And you don't really want to use them as Link Father, unless of course you like get a lot of advantage off of that. And Isolde is one of those advantage plays. Upon summon, search like trainer, for example, or the manager, right? The manager. That again, okay, cannot be used during your turn, but again, it gives you some pop negation during your opponent's turn. While at the same time, if you have that level 1 warrior in your deck, or other targets for Isolde, it keeps extending your plays, and if you look at the extra deck, it just opens up more Link plays as well. So as a whole, it just gives the deck more options, right? So this is good. I mean, Nibiru, you have to. I feel you just have to, because every deck is running the Jet Synchron package, and that's just such a huge problem for the deck. You have to play like hand traps or whatever. So dropping Ace to the field, now I can negate any card by discarding something, right? And okay, yeah, Scoop Face, that's cool. But the Foolish Burial of Goods, I feel, because the deck is somewhat still inconsistent, could send a trap to the graveyard, the older trap, forgot its name. You know, just banish it and basically search like any UA spell, for example, from your deck. Most of the time it will be one of your field spells, because you want to have that combination of both, like, the Hyper Stadium, I believe the name is, and the other field spell, UA Stadium. Like, both field spells, again, getting those beneficial summons, the extra normal summon plus the double search, is quite strong. So again, ending with the Appaloosa and just leaving one of the level 4s on the field, and I do opt to go for the new one. The new one has the ability to, let's say, and that's, well, it's not really the downside, but it can tag out itself, so send itself back to your hand. But you have to send like a high level UA monster from your hand to the deck, and then you can special summon something from the deck. So it's like a small hero lifts, if that makes sense. So it recycles through your engine, and most of the time, since I'm running that Monster Reborn one, again, I've seen builds that are not running it, but I think you have to, especially because I'm somewhat focusing myself on Isolde, and again, Isolde sets up your monsters in the graveyard as Link materials, and then Rebounder, that was the name I was looking for, just gives you the opportunity to special summon it during your opponent's turn, and then Reborn something, Debris Dragon something, during your opponent's turn. So again, it definitely works well together. It's not optimal, it's not as inconsistent like Eldritch Synchro or Necros, whatever, it doesn't need to be, but the deck still lacks power, right? I feel it's very similar to like a Protect the Castle strategy. But even then, it's quite fragile. So getting both level 4s on the field, midfielder was a first level 4, if I'm correct with the name. I feel it's currently a 1-off, might be a 2-off, maybe a 2-off, right? But again, yeah, the deck is already sitting at 44 cards. Maybe if you like drop the Isolde package, I would probably like fit in maybe another midfielder. At 2 is fine, because you have some like a lot of searches in the deck to search out your monsters. You don't really want to clock your hand. But yeah, then again, Rota might also be an option instead of the second midfielder, but again, that's up to you, right? So this is, I guess, an okay hand. Obviously, Call by the Grave, triple staple. You need to prevent your opponent from using a hand trap, even though this deck isn't really hindered by hand traps. Okay, your opponent could use like an Ash Blossom on your field spell, preventing a search. That hurts, that definitely hurts, because you need that that search, right? You need the beneficial searches. So yeah, again, nice field, I guess. Turning the, and that's one of the level 7s, as like that monster negation effect, it will not destroy the monster, but it will switch the battle position, so that's something again to keep in mind. Going for some extra damage, Dunker is a good one. I've seen builds main decking more Dunker, not really sure if I want to main deck it more actually. I mean, it's a good card to like break through established boards, But the problem is that the current format in 2020 is that established boards contain like 6 or 7 negates, and the problem is that this deck is not able to play through that. And first of all, getting the Dunker on the field and, you know, like deal damage, getting the pop effect and so on. So yeah, this is game, right? Yeah, indeed, extravagance for the beneficial draws, but yeah, putting the, what's this called, Apprentice Illusion Magician into attack position, and now, yeah, basically any monster could deal the last damage. The Eldritch is not going to help too much, getting the extra, well, the normal summon here, the beneficial search, dropping the trainer, the manager to my side of the field for the potential pop, but yeah, the Golden Land does pop here. But again, not going to matter too much. Go for second, dissolve the equip, and, you know, baning or gaining the beneficial attack points and go for game. So the UA deck, it's cool. 44 cards to the main deck. You could definitely drop the Isolde package if you want. Maybe add in like one extra deck monster. I'm not running the other ones, like the level 5 that prevents your opponent from activating cards. Well, it might be a one-off. Yeah, maybe a one-off. But outside, I don't see myself running like more copies of the like the more spare copies in the main deck, right? Again, just trying to keep the deck as consistent as possible. But yeah, again, feel free to like give suggestions like always. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Liam signing out. Peace.